All right, that's interesting. This comes at a time when you also have other alternative modes of investment into real estate, which didn't exist in India for the longest period of time. Something like the real estate investment trusts or REITs, which were listed in India only just a couple of years ago, but it has found some traction. Help us understand, where do REITs as an investment avenue stand for the average investor?
So, Mr. Krishna Kumar, let me give a little longish answer. First of all, let me explain to our viewers what is a REIT. The REIT is an investment done by an institution for the purposes of doing properties which are almost all rented out. So you get a secure kind of return or a semi-secured return over a period of time, and it's invested into a property. So there are two components of the income that comes to a REIT. One, which comes in terms of rental income, which is a secured one, and the REIT is required to dividend out 90% of the income every year. So that becomes a major matter in terms of the returns that you get. So by and large, REITs have two returns. One, in terms of returns on interest, which is dividend out, or in terms of capital gains over a period of time. In the case of InvITs, you get a return because they are relating to infrastructure projects. So that is an advantage. The advantage of a REIT or an InvIT, as distinguished from equity, that there is a lower amount of risk in terms of investment into a REIT, and also the fact that you can put smaller amounts into a REIT, 50,000 now, originally it was 2 lakhs of rupees minimum. And this combination of the factor makes it easy for a common person to invest into a property. The only difference, Mr. Krishna Kumar, is that you really cannot use the property. While in the case of actually buying a property, giving it out on rent, if tomorrow you want it for your children, for your future, and other aspects of it, you have solid property, not just a piece of paper. So I think that is an advantage to it. And in the years of inflation, nowadays you don't have high rates of inflation. In the good old days, you would have 8%, 9% inflation rates. The property prices constantly zoomed around and all. But even today, looking at steel and other cement prices, it's obvious that the properties in terms of rates are going to go up over a period of time if such high rates of building materials are going to continue to grow. So there is a huge opportunity, A, into investment into property, and as you mentioned, alternative investments into REITs or InvITs.
Right. Having said that, Mr. Hiranandani, there are exactly three REITs that are listed in India, three REITs available for investment. There's Brookfield, and a couple of others. Talk to us, these three REITs and the way they've performed over the last 2 years since they've been listed. What needs to be kept in mind before people go to invest their money in REITs?
So by and large, the REITs are excellent. All three of them have done extremely well, and over a period of time, they will only do better. Do better because of the COVID times. Properties in terms of leasehold properties have been challenged because people have been working from home. So obviously, the returns which you see in terms of appreciation of the REITs are not so good. But over a period of time, you'll definitely see appreciation in the REITs, which will be much more. But remember, worldwide, Krishna Kumar, it's not, people don't invest into REITs so much for capital appreciation, but for a steady flow of income. So that's the difference in terms of a worldwide perception of what REITs and InvITs are, and capital appreciation is a secondary factor. And hence, most people, when they actually go for the REITs, they want to say, "Oh, I want a secure return for my family and the future, and I'm not looking at as much into capital appreciation as I would in terms of buying a house or buying equity into the marketplace." That's the major distinction of how I would like to position a REIT and an InvIT.
Right. And you're talking about REITs in India, and REITs in India, all three of them are focused on office properties, because, you know, REITs across the world invest in any income generating property. It could be a mall, hotel, anything. But in India, all the three REITs focus on office properties. And we've seen how work from home has literally taken over the work culture in India and across the world. And, you know, there's so much talk of, you know, office space demand taking a hit. How much of a risk is it to invest in an Indian REIT that focuses on office space?
I am very certain that there is almost zero risk in long term in terms of investing into a REIT in the commercial markets which are there today. They are all invested into super AAA rated properties. They are beautiful properties. They are all given to multinationals and other companies. Of course, during COVID time, there could be some vacancies which could not be predicted, but the properties are so good that they are definitely going to be taken up soon. Could be short-term vacancies, but not long-term problems. So I don't see a risk profile at all in terms of the REITs or InvITs. Also, the fact that properties over a period of time could become more valuable. And so you may, at the end of it, maybe 5-10 years, also see a capital appreciation in terms of the properties which are there, which may not be available in the case of an InvIT. So this is a major distinction again between a REIT and an InvIT.